All right, let's get you that big story tonight in an explosive twist. Sacked Mumbai top cop Parambir Singh has accused the Maharashtra Home Minister of corruption. The shunted police commissioner, Parambir Singh, replaced as Mumbai Police Commissioner over reported lapses in the Mukesh Ambani security scare probe, has written a letter to the Chief Minister accusing the Maharashtra Home Minister, Anil Deshmukh, of malpractices. I'm quoting there, malpractices, he says in his letter. In sensational claims, the former Mumbai Police Commissioner says, and I'm reading out from this letter, that Anil Deshmukh had directed the suspended API Sachin Vaze to collect 100 crore rupees every month from bars and restaurants. The sub-inspector Sachin Vaze, who was heading the crime intelligence unit of the crime branch of the Mumbai police, was called by Anil Deshmukh, the home minister, to his official residence several times in the past few months, he says in this letter, and repeatedly instructed to assist in the collection of funds for the Honorable Home Minister. He goes on to say that in February, the state Home Minister had called the inspector, Vaze, to his official residence, and in the presence of his personal secretary, he expressed to Vaze that he had a target to accumulate 100 crore rupees a month. That is what the letter says to the Chief Minister. It goes on to say that the Honorable Home Minister has, as a regular practice, repeatedly been calling my officers and giving them instructions in respect to the course of to be followed by them in the performance of their official duties. He says the Home Minister has been calling my officers to his official residence, bypassing me and other superior officers of the police department to whom these respective police officers report to. The letter goes on to say that the Honorable Home Minister has been instructing them to carry out official assignments and collection schemes, including financial transactions, as per his instructions, based on his expectations and targets to collect money. He goes on to say in this letter that I may humbly submit that I take full responsibility of my police force. However, the instances of interference make it clear that the responsibility of wrongdoings may lie somewhere else, he says, at the door of the wrongdoers. He ends his letter by saying, I have been made a scapegoat to divert attention from the actual wrongdoers. Meanwhile, we do have a reaction from Anil Deshmukh. He has responded to the explosive letter by Parambir Singh, alleging that the former Mumbai police commissioner was leveling false charges to save himself from further legal action. You can see there Maharashtra's politics taking a whole new turn. The BJP has now launched a massive offensive. They're demanding that Anil Deshmukh be removed over his ties with the suspended encounter specialist, as he's called, Sachin Vaze, as the BJP has been calling him. Even earlier, the BJP leaders had accused the Maharashtra government of shielding Vaze, who is a key suspect in the Ambani House bomb scare and the Mansukh Hirain death cases. Maharashtra's leader of opposition, Devendra Fadnavis, the former chief minister, is going for the jugular.
Mumbai ke purv police commissioner aur serving DG Shri Parambir Singh inhone patra ke madhyam se jo aarop lagaye hai wo atyant gambhir hai. Vishesh roop se in aaropon ki gambhirta isliye bhi badhti hai ki ye aarop ek serving DG ne lagaye hue aur in aaropon ke sath uski pushti karne ke liye उन्होंने व्हाट्सएप चैट या एसएमएस चैट, जो भी कुछ वो समझ में नहीं आ रहा उस लेटर में से कौन सी चैट है, लेकिन जो चैट उन्होंने लगाई हुई है इसमें बिल्कुल स्पष्टता के साथ वो जिनके साथ बातचीत हो रही है वो कह रहे हैं कि इतने रेस्टोरेंट से इतने पैसे, इतने बार से इतने पैसे, इतना पैसा जमा करने को बोला है. तो ये एक बहुत ही सबल इस प्रकार का एक, मैं ऐसा मानता हूं कि उनके खिलाफ एविडेंस है. ऐसे समय हमारी मांग है कि गृह मंत्री जी ने तुरंत इस्तीफा देना चाहिए. वो नहीं देते हैं तो उनको मुख्यमंत्री जी ने हटाना चाहिए और इसकी निष्पक्ष जांच होनी चाहिए.
All right, for more on this first, let's go across to NDTV, Sanket Upadhyay. Sanket, this is really explosive. Now, the letter here says that in mid-March, the letter is dated for today. It says that in mid-March, Singh went to the chief minister to brief him. He says that one of the briefing sessions in the wake of the Antilia incident held in mid-March, I was called late evening to brief you. You, he's talking about the chief minister. He says, I had pointed out several misdeeds and malpractices being indulged into by the Honorable Home Minister. So, Sanket, according to this letter, Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray was aware all along of what was going on. This, at least according to Singh, this has not been sprung onto the Chief Minister right now. And it seems like the act wasn't, the letter is an act of desperation because he wasn't being heard.
Sarah, this is an explosive letter. In the words of Devendra Fadnavis, far more explosive than those gelatin sticks. The reason why it is explosive, because this letter in one stroke blames everyone. I mean, it can be rubbished as just allegation, but the nature of the allegations are such that they are specific, and that too coming in from a favorite, a darling, former top cop, who's a Mumbai police commissioner, Parambir Singh. So these are extremely important points that he seems to be making. The first point is where he blames Anil Deshmukh directly, the Home Minister, who is, by the way, still his reporting manager right now. He's a DG rank official even now. So if Parambir Singh is blaming his own boss, then you can understand the gravity of the situation. He says that I repeatedly brought this up. We all know about the allegation of 100 crore rupees per month, a target being set for Sachin Waze. So naturally, there is a question. If this was a target allegedly for Sachin Waze, were there more targets set for others by the Home Minister? Who will probe this? Can Maharashtra police probe this under the leadership of Anil Deshmukh? Will that not be a conflict of interest? Will that not be a messy affair? Because how can you expect an impartial probe? And the point that you were raising, that is going to be very, very significant. It's not like Shiv Sena has been given a bailout package by Parambir Singh. He says that I brought this to your notice as well. So how does Mr. Uddhav Thackeray explain his silence? That is why this entire matter has turned intensely political and also will make perhaps the Aghadi partners very, very uncomfortable. Now, it will be interesting to see that in the wake of this explosive letter, will these Maharashtra Vikas Aghadi partners choose to stay together and fight this politically, though it appears very difficult, or they are going to be fragmented and thus lose their government. So, political fallout is going to be this. And then, of course, Sarah, the important point of who probes this? Will the Maharashtra government probe this or the Maharashtra police? How tenable will that probe be? Or should a central agency be probing this? All of this are questions that are unanswered in what is undoubtedly extremely explosive.
But first, one point we must raise over here, that the letter doesn't seem to have been signed by Mr. Singh. Though that said, when you talk about the contents, he does actually quote a text. As of now, going by the contents, it's not just an allegation made by Mr. Singh. Many would raise the point, Sanket, that he has only raised this allegation once he has been shunted out of that post. That said, there's detailed an exchange between him and a police officer. It's almost as if Mr. Singh is putting, has collated proof and put that down in this letter. So it's more, is it more than just a mere accusation and allegation right now?
Absolutely. So, and we must not forget, he was the Mumbai police commissioner. He's still a DG rank officer. And more importantly, he's the guy in charge of many probes. So I'm pretty sure, and we can say this safely, that a cop will have his story right. So if he's alleging something, he will definitely have proof. It is the nature of his job to not allege without proof. So if that is the case, yes, the timing is going to be suspect. I mean, why did he not bring this up earlier? He tries to mention that very briefly in his letter, where in that unsigned letter, again, a very nice point pointed out by you, He mentions that I brought this to the notice of the chief minister. So he's trying to bail himself out. That it's not like now that I am a disgruntled man, I am coming up with these allegations. I brought this to your notice earlier as well.
All right, so many, many angles. This is certainly going to be the story all of tomorrow. Is this cop being shielded by the state? Many questions. Let's go across to our panelists. Let's bring in Sanjay Gupta, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena. PK Jain, former Mumbai Police Commissioner, joining us. Sanjay Jha, author, columnist, Congressi by DNA, he says. PKD Nambiar, political analyst who supports the BJP. First and foremost, Sanjay Gupta of the Shiv Sena, what is your reaction? Is this a police officer who is being shielded by the state? Because the BJP, they're demanding an impartial probe. Who is going to conduct this probe? As Sanket points out, they're questioning the role of the chief minister, the former chief minister. Mr. Fadnavis says the letter also states the chief minister was intimated about this earlier. Why did he not act on this?
बहुत ही प्रारंभिक स्टेज है. जब तक कि मुख्यमंत्री साहब इन दोनों चीजों पर जांच नहीं कर लेते, जब तक कि वो इस जांच करने के बाद किसी निष्कर्ष पर नहीं पहुंचते, तब तक अभी इस स्टेज पर मेरे लिए कुछ भी कहना थोड़ा मुश्किल है. मुझे लगता है कि इस मामले में जब तक कि उन दोनों के बयानों को देख करके जांच नहीं हो जाती और खुद उद्धव साहब इस पर कोई बयान नहीं देते या प्रतिक्रिया नहीं देते. अभी इस विषय में सब मीटिंगें चल रही है, सरकार इस सब चीजों को देख रही है और देखने के बाद इस पर जब तक कोई निर्णय लेकर के कोई ऑफिशियल बयान नहीं देती, तब तक मैं अभी कुछ नहीं कह पाऊंगा.
ऑलराइट सर, यू मे नॉट से एनीथिंग नाउ, बट कैन यू टॉक अबाउट व्हाट्स हैपेंड इन द पास्ट? बिकॉज़ द बीजेपी इज रेजिंग दैट. नितेश राणे हैज ट्वीटेड सेइंग दैट इट्स लाउड एंड क्लियर हु वाजेज पॉलिटिकल बॉस इज. He says, who asked for his reinstatement in the force during the last government? Who advocated for him during the current Vidhan Sabha, saying he's not with? It's Uddhav Thackeray. You cannot speak until an investigation is done, but people will be looking at the way the Sena has reacted in the past.
देखिए, सभी मामलों को मिक्स नहीं किया जा सकता. सचिन वाजे की रीइंस्टेटमेंट, उसकी पोस्टिंग, वो एक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव मैटर था. मनसुख हिरेन केस, वो एक अलग केस है. एटीएस से जांच, एटीएस की जांच करते समय भी उस समय एनआईए का उसके बीच में आना, वो एक अलग बात है. ये जो एक प्रकरण है, ये एक अलग केस है. हर चीज को मिक्स नहीं किया जा सकता. तो इस विषय में तो मैं जब तक कोई भी बयान अभी नहीं दे पाऊंगा, जब तक कि ऑफिशियल तौर पर खुद उद्धव साहब, चीफ मिनिस्टर साहब इसको देख करके इस पर किस तरह का एक्शन, क्योंकि इस सभी विषय में संज्ञान लिया जा रहा है, सभी विषय में देखा जा रहा है.
ओके, और सरकार इस पे गंभीर है. मिस्टर गुप्ता, नॉट सेइंग मच देयर. Mr. Deshmukh's reaction, what do you make of the reactions we're getting so far? Mr. Deshmukh's reaction is in stark contrast to what the Sena's stand has been, because the Sena has been defending Singh, saying that his transfer did not make him a criminal. They said there was a lobby in Delhi that was upset because of the TRP scam that came to light during his tenure. What are you making of this so far?
Sarah, you know, I mean, without getting into the details of these allegations, because as you rightly pointed out, this is going to be the stage of mutual recriminations. Mr. Singh has just been transferred from the job, a very prestigious job as the Mumbai Police Commissioner. And, you know, everybody will have an axe to grind. So, you know, this is the regular part for the course. I'm not flabbergasted by anything that is going on. But the larger issue remains that this is a very murky affair, very foggy affair. Right from the time that you heard about those gelatin sticks outside Mr. Ambani's home, it appears to be very fishy. And, you know, the fundamental point, Sarah, that we all need to discuss today, and I hope Mr. Jain will mention that, because he's a former Mumbai cop.
Absolutely.
That until you have police reforms in India, until the political system uses the law enforcement agency for its own political purposes, whether it's fundraising, extortion, or harassing a political opponent, we will remain. This is a banana republic situation. Can you imagine? I live here in the city. This is the commercial hotspot of this country. The most powerful business person, one of the richest in the world, has an assassination attempt on his family. A cop of the city is allegedly involved. And now you have an allegation from the head of the police against the home minister. I mean, this is a very tragic commentary for the city I live in, because right now, Sarah, we are being devastated by the coronavirus.
Absolutely.
What a tragedy for the city.
And that is where the administration should be focusing its attentions on. As of now, the spokesperson for the Shiv Sena, Mr. Gupta, says there's a meeting, but the meeting is not on the rising cases and the lives that are being taken every day in Maharashtra. But Mr. PK Jain, former Mumbai Police Commissioner, please come in over here. The biggest issue plaguing the police force is political interference.
Sarah has been maintaining over the last few days and otherwise in discussions also that police is always under the thumb of the political masters. Any officer who's liked by them is given plum postings. When I say plum postings, there are field postings, the desirable postings. Any officer who does not listen to them, who does not toe their line, is always thrown on the sideline. Mr. Jha just now mentioned about the police reforms. I can vouch and I can say with authority that none of the political parties is interested in the police reforms. Nobody wants the police to be independent. Everybody wants the police to be under their thumb to carry out their wishes in terms of arrest, in terms of enforcement, in terms of doing whatever they want to do, in terms of collections. Now it was always in the shadows that whether police was being used for collections also. Now today's letter has made even that clear. Let me specify two, three things. Paramveer Singh has now come out with this letter because, number one, he's giving specific examples, he's giving specific dates and persons who were present in such meetings when the money was demanded.
Correct.
So to my mind, an offense under the Anti-Corruption Act should be registered right away, and Mr. Deshmukh has no right to continue in his position, because if Paramveer Singh can be removed from his position for carrying out a fair probe, then I think by the same analogy, Mr. Deshmukh has no business to continue in his position. Whether the charges are true or false is a different matter altogether.
Hmm.
Number two, Mr. Paramveer Singh even today is a serving officer. If he has leveled charges in writing, it is serious, and obviously he would be having some fodder, some material to back up his claims, which he will come out at the right time. So I think the situation has come down to a level where it is a slap on the face of Maharashtra government. It is a slap on the face of Maharashtra police that we've gone down to a level that these things have come out so openly. Hmm. This was all in the shadows. It was all being rumored in the past.
Hmm.
But now I think the things have gone beyond a point. And the political interference, I think
Mr. Jain, what would you say to those, point out that if this is true, the allegations here, the Singh is also responsible in a sense because he kept quiet till he was shunted.
See, there's only one thing which comes to his rescue, as he has mentioned in this, that he brought this to the notice of the Chief Minister, he brought it to the notice of Deputy Chief Minister, he brought
but
it to the
But this has been going on for some
NCP
time.
Supremo. He also brought it to the notice of the NCP Supremo. So
yes.
I think he has been keeping his slate to some extent. He can be given some brownie points for that. But yes, if Wazir was doing extortion on his behalf or on the behalf of the minister and he was keeping quiet, I think he's also a party to it. I think this is all a matter of investigation once an offence under the Anti-Corruption Act is registered. And in the meantime, we should not forget that the basic picture of the gelatin being planted outside the house of Mr. Ambani and the probe into that, that was pointing to a different party and different line altogether. This has all come now, though in his own letter, Mr. Singh has not mentioned why this vehicle was planted outside the residence of Mr. Ambani. This was not a part of the 100 crore rupees
yes.
extortion.
No,
plan.
They're completely separate. So they're two separate things.
Yeah, they're two separate things. But
many,
now,
many unanswered questions, many gaping holes in the story, not sure what the story really is over here. But Mr. Gupta, please respond to what Sanjay Jha has pointed out, what Mr. Jain has pointed out. Can we actually have an investigation into this matter if the allegations are against the Home Minister who would be overseeing this investigation? Does he need to step down purely so that an investigation can take place and we can know, arrive at the truth? Mr. Gupta,
इसमें मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि इस पे जब तक की सरकार इस तरह के आरोप लगने के बाद जिस तरह से आरोप लगे हैं एक टॉप कॉप ने जिस तरह से आरोप लगाए हैं एक मिनिस्टर के खिलाफ तो जब तक की सरकार इसको सब कुछ देख करके जब तक ऑफिशियल कोई बात नहीं कहती तब तक मैंने आपको पहले कहा कि उससे पहले मैं कुछ भी अभी नहीं कह पाऊंगा तो सरकार इसको गंभीर है
ऑल राइट मिस्टर नंबियार प्लीज कम इन ओवर देयर मिस्टर गुप्ता सेज ही कांट मेक एनी स्टेटमेंट्स ऑन दिस मैटर राइट नाउ बीजेपी क्लियरली गोइंग फॉर द जगुलर राइट नाउ
सारा व्हाट कैन यू एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम अ पार्टी व्हिच इज इन अ वेरी स्टिंगिंग स्कैम आफ्टर स्कैम एवरी डे यू आर हियरिंग वन ऑफ वर्स्ट स्टोरीज व्हिच वी हैव एवर हर्ड फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र is considered to be one of the most respected state or one of the largest and most progressive state in the country. Ever since this, I would say that I was always maintaining that I think COVID ne abhi tak samala hai is party or is agadi ko. Ab mujhe lagta hai ki even the COVID is not going to help them out. I think the time has come for both the Maharashtra government and this alliance to quit and call
but
for
Mr.
a new
Nambiar,
election.
We don't know how long this was lasting because the Shiv Sena and the BJP were allies. They've been the oldest allies.
We are talking about the current government. Let me ask you this, Sara, and this is the question which everybody needs to be answering. Today, we are using the uniform to collect the money, bribe, corruption. What all names you will name to all these scams, what we are seeing it in Maharashtra. We are hearing that the uniform is used to collect money. For how long will you be able to save this government? Whether who or are scapegoats in this, whether it is I believe.
Okay.
I think, Sarai, I want a minute more. So yesterday's Anil Deshmukh met the Sharad Pawar.
Yes.
Uddhav Thackeray himself was taking the briefing. Where was this whole briefing was going? Sachin Waze was supported by the same Sanjay Gupta in the same channel along with me. Sachin Waze was supported by the Shiv Sena one after another. Why they were all holding on to these people? If there is dal mein sirf kala nahi hai, dal pura hi kala hai.
All right, Sanjay Jha, the BJP on a clear wicket here, you think a very important point that both Sanket raised and Mr. Nambiar are raising. 2 days after Singh was shunted out of office, Anil Deshmukh met with the NCP chief, Sharad Pawar. And after that meeting, Mr. Pawar came out, said, and made a statement very confidently saying, "We do not believe that an arrest of Sachin Waze will impact the state government." In hindsight, what can one read into that statement and the political repercussions of this?
Mr. Nambiar,
if you speak, both speak together, nobody is going to be under.
Sarah, a simple point. Over the coming days, you are going to hear a lot of expose. Because I can tell you, I live here in Mumbai, and the police officers, many of them who are currently in the news and many who are not in the news, have actually served under different political dispensations and have actually had very similar performance issues. I'm not exaggerating that. They will be out in the public domain. And it is rather rich for Mr. Nambiar to wax eloquent on police independence when we know that encounter specialists have been encouraged by various BJP states. I don't want to even name them. So let us not try and act holier than thou at the moment.
All right. Nobody is beyond or reproach in this matter. Sure, more will come out over the next few days. But thank you all for joining us, and all of you in Maharashtra, stay safe. We were not even able to focus on the very important story about the number of cases on the rise in Maharashtra, and that is the sad tragedy tonight. Thank you all, though, for your time. Bye-bye.